This is another MyView TV exclusive. Please remember to hit the notification bell, like, share, and subscribe.
Don't bring nobody forward in your future for me. Everything what you see up, my natural talent. Let me tell you something. You see, when you know what to please the audience with, it's simple, me.
Wagwan, well, my people. Hope everybody doing okay. Hope everybody doing alright. Yes, another Sunday. We have to start the week same way like how we end the week. So I forgive praises unto the Most High. A lot of persons don't do it, but we have to do it. Our platform kind of different, and so we always do it. So we continue on this part. All right, people. Remember now, later we live, so they can tune in and let's all have vibes. You know, Sunday program kind of different, as we said before. If look more, just come tune in with it. Isaiah 41 and verse 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Mr. People, I have an update for you. Because yesterday, I play a voice note and a pack of pressure under my DM. My viewer lie the voice note, I tell. No, go so. People all in the comment section can go back and look on it. But my view, a line of voice note, that tell nothing really, no go so. I'm sorry, right? Remember, I'm showing you a picture. So right now, you can look on the screen because I'm going to show you a picture again. The St. Catherine police are increasing their presence in the Gregory Park area following Thursday evening fatal shooting of two men in the community. The deceased has been identified as 42-year-old Colin Culcress and Josh Hooks. At about 6 o'clock, the three men were standing at Cottage Drive in Gregory Park when a vehicle drove up. Gunmen in the vehicle shot the three men. It is reported that section of Gregory Park has been tense in recent weeks. Two men were shot in the community last Friday. So, hold on. I lied. The voice note that tell now. Me wonder if I lied. The voice note that tell, like, I'm sure somebody, boy, know them two men, they were drop out and can't come and test with the facts, eh? Them drop out for real. Never see a letter of them yet so much yet. Allegation, allegedly. Oh Jesus. Can't catch criminal and keep on using these words. But anyway, that's not my problem. Man who allegedly broke into an 88-year-old woman's house in Buff Bay, Portland and attempted to rape her has been arrested and charged on Thursday, August 27. The accused man is 26-year-old Otis McKenzie of Woodstock District in Buff Bay, Portland. Yeah man, old raper boy Otis McKenzie. The whole community is supposed to know Otis McKenzie. I'm coming from the McKenzie side of the family. Yes, that little rapper boy there from in a Buff Bay, Portland. Who don't know him? Big 26-year-old boy who I rape the big old woman, which is 88. I mean, I understand. I mean, I'm violent about the message she old, but the lady's old. She's 88-year-old. Could have been great-great-grandmother. And he might try to rape her. No, sir. Reports from the Buff Bay police that at about 10 p.m. the elderly woman was awakened by a man inside her house. He alleged Adam to remove her clothes and a strong report ensued, and amidst it, the woman changed her tactics in a bid to save her life. He offered a raper boy, yes, Otis McKenzie, 26 Otis McKenzie from Bull Bay, money, and he accepted the offer, took the money and left the home. The police were summoned and a report was made. McKenzie was arrested during a police operation and was later charged for a burglary assault with intention to rape. He scheduled to appear at the Portland Parish Court on Tuesday, September 1st. Me, I go go no. The rest of the story, I may get it, people. Because, yes, it's Tuesday coming. We are going to go down to the court and we are going to find some people go down to the court and get the raper boy picture. So everybody in the community can know. Say, watch out. Otis McKenzie. Mass McKenzie, son and Mama McKenzie, boy. Him. Him is a raper. Him try off for the 88-year-old lady and him take her money when she decides to watch her. Maybe give her the money. Though trouble her a little something what she have. The boy. You see them boy there? Me not have no pity for them. Right now, I tell you the truth. Him not fi make it to court. Him not fi make it to court. I mean, nobody come tell me say, yo, no, give a chance. No. We not give them no chance. No. Beg for no chance for them. We not give them no chance. Him not fi make it out of the station if we go to court. Right now, if it's supposed to hear same family, the McKenzie family are planning a burial for him. I don't feel like if we just get up every day and plead by the end of the folks them and try to take with them thing and try to mash up with them. Work so hard to achieve. Some of you boys don't want to work, you know. Some of you boys and girls don't want to work. Yeah, you know, youths. I thought the truth. You know how it works. That's what I see. Grandma and grandpa with them look at things where them struggle for years for half. You don't want to come take it from them. You don't want to come take it from them. That's not right. that cannot, and will never be right. The big C and the nightly curfew restriction imposed by the government have hit an elderly Maninsville Road vendor in his pocket after being targeted by thieves 3 nights this week. Vendor of 25-year Everton Short Richards, 58, said he has never experienced anything near this type of infringement, which has caused him to lose his night rest and money. Short is uniquely popular in section of St. Andrew for his 24-hour curbside dependable service. Hey man, so you know, people who are coming from party, I want a party, I want a drink, I want a smoke. To start the night, that man they ever dip on the road, right through like night through. However, popularity did not deter thief from breaking into his stall at will during the nightly curfew hours. Told the paper that daily he served his loyal customer base, closed the business and left the street for home in Redhills. The incident which occurred Sunday, Wednesday and Friday saw him losing close to 100,000. Like, serious, but why is it that the man, the same man, them when him selling that, the same man, them come beg him a thing, you know, him give a thing, you know, people, and the same man, them come rob him, you know. The same man, them same man come rob him. He reported the matter to the Constance Spring police station, who showed us the receipt. Monday morning, I come down here and them take out everything out of the stall and I go report it up at the station. Wednesday morning again, I see the same operation, and last night, me in my bed about 2 o'clock and mommy answered the phone. The police said I must come secure my things them, call them invade the stand. Richard was displeased that although he got the call, the police didn't apprehend anyone. The police tell me about him see man with drinks and a madman. How him know he's a madman? Before the man hold the man, see him like how him call me out of my bed. Why call me and you not hold the man? And I uno alone for them on the road. It is understand that the thief used an object to pull the lock on the door and took away several items. Richard told our news team that the thief made off with more than 10 crates of bottle and assorted rum, liquor, lighter, cash during their spree. But Richard, I know your place still and I'm the normal thief, but why left your money there, Papa? Next time, don't left the money. Alright, brother? Don't left your money in there. He is broken, even as he contends that his stall once operated 24 hours free of trouble. And from the curfew time, because we never used to lose nothing. This place never have on a door, and the last 5 years doors put on, Richard said. Me out here around 23 years and them things yeah, never used to happen. A while gone, he questioned. The Constance Spring police told us that the report was made and investigation is underway. I guess the police are going to look for a madman with them they see a drinking juice, because remember, you know, them see madman a drink juice and them never lock him up. But I don't understand why they never lock a madman. See, I think they should lock him up too, because probably he's of sound mind. He probably not some dirty clothes, but he's of sound mind. He know him a do. Customers who stopped by the shop and learned of the reported thief were alarmed at the development. A customer told us that everybody in a St. Andrew depend on show 24 hours and the curfew caused him to lock up his place and people rob him. This is slackness. The police must put a stop to it. But let me tell you something, people. There's little and no more the police can do. You understand? The police, them can't put a stop to everything, you know. Sometimes you have to secure your business for yourself. You see him say, him know say, the people them don't target him, you know. Remember, you know, him a talk about from curfew and big C come in, make people a thief and them have going off the road. Why a 5 years now you put on door? You're there with 23 years. And since five years of curfew are gone, that's that more. I mean, I blame him still, but I'm just gonna show you this. Sometimes, when you're in a situation where you have something, you can't get too comfortable, because you come a time when people will get hungry and they will come attack you. That, you give them the right to come attack you, you know? You don't give them the right, but time you are living in, you have to be mindful of these persons who are going to walk around and come take what belongs to you, like the things that you and them work so hard to get it. Just a very unfortunate situation. I mean, when nobody come and cuss me, hear me, I say, I get it wrong. And I've finished this, so the whole review would understand where I say. Very unfortunate situation. I mean, I wish that bad nobody, because I say 23 years you're out there and everything nice. But sometimes when they are placed for 23 years, trouble are gonna come. And what you are gonna do in order to stop the trouble, you have to put on the door like what you do, and you have to lock up your system good. Then again, you never have to lock it up and you're out there right through, because you work on shift. Sometimes you are there, sometimes you have the next girl jumping on them around you, but I said when they got my whole arrest. But yeah, I get me. You see, every downfall is for a greater comeback shout. So if you hear this, me I tell you this, say, yo, you see, a comeback, I could be better. So you don't need to worry. You don't need to worry right now. Somebody could come and go, so boom, and put out two grill pan that for you. and you're all right. And don't leave your money in a stall and them something there. When you can go and go lock it, you go and lock it. All right, short. Always remember, tell a friend, forward, because my view there. And we are chat a bag of things and we are going with a bag of something. But later, tune in Panda Life. Tune in Panda Life. Whichever course you're there, just look out for the time. It's 5, I think of 5 Jamaican time, and 6 of a foreign time, and night over England. I wish for me there, wish for me there right now at 12 o'clock, so you know, say, at them time. All right, people, so look at me.